Namaskar. Good morning, everybody. Today we have assembled here to commemorate and celebrate the life journey of late Shri Fali Nariman. May I request all of you to stand up for 2 minutes silence to pay tribute. Thank you very much. Mr. Acharya, please come in the front row. Mr. Acharya, Mr. B.B. Acharya. Shri R. Venkat Ramani ji, Attorney General for India. Mr. Prashant Kumar, President, Bar Association of India. Mr. Chandiyog, President-elect, Bar Association of India. Shri Janak Dwarka Das Ji, Vice President, Bar Association of India. Mr. Shyam Devan, Vice President, Bar Association of India and President, Law Asia. Dr. Lalit Bhasin, former President, Bar Association of India. Mr. Nitin Thakkar, President, High Court Bar Association. Mr. Subhash Sharma, Advocate. Mr. Acharya, our veteran participant all these conferences, former AG of Karnataka, Mr. Mukesh, Joint Secretary, Mr. Vibhu, Joint Secretary, Mr. Thaniru Srinivas, Joint Secretary, Bar Association of India, state secretaries from various states, Meghalaya, Rajasthan, led by Mr. Roshan Lal Jain, Meghalaya, led by Ms. Pooja, my other colleagues, members of the Bar Association of India, ladies and gentlemen. Introduction to Fali S. Nariman is like showing lamp to the sun. He was the Bhish Pitama of the legal fraternity. For the past several years, the Bar Association of India has been organizing the Rule of Law Convention annually. Shri Fali Nariman was President of India for 19 years, and he has always been associated with this annual convention. In this session, we commemorate and celebrate the journey of his life. Fali Nariman, often hailed as one of the India's foremost legal luminaries, one of the most influential legal legends, has left an indelible mark on the country's legal landscape. His sharp intellect, unwavering integrity, and profound commitment to justice have inspired generations of lawyers. His contributions to constitutional law and his fearless advocacy for civil liberties will continue to resonate for years to come. Fali Nariman was born on 10th January 1929 in Rangoon. He was alumni of Government Law College, Bombay. He initially practiced in Bombay High Court and later shifted his practice to the Supreme Court of India. He was designated as senior advocate in the year 1971 and was appointed Additional Solicitor General of India in 1972. When emergency was imposed in the nation in the year 1975, in the aftermath of the then Prime Minister losing her election petition, which was filed to challenge her election as member of Lok Sabha, Mr. Nariman resigned in protest on the suppression of civil liberties. He was honored with Padma Bhushan in 1991 and with Padma Vibhushan in 2017, the third and second highest honors granted to a civilian by the President of India. Both awards were for Mr. Nariman's contribution to jurisprudence and public affairs. He was also a recipient of Gruber Prize for Justice in the year 2002. Shri Fali was President of the Bar Association of India from 1991 to 2010. He had been the President of Law Asia during the years 1985 to 1987. He was nominated member of the Raj Sabha from 1999 to 2005. During his tenure as parliamentarian, he introduced four private members' bill in the Raj Sabha, namely the disruption of proceedings of parliament, disentitlement of allowances to members bill 2004, the Judicial Statistics Bill 2004, the Constitution Amendment Bill 2004 to amend Article 217 and 224 of the Constitution, the Representation of People's Amendment Bill 2004. He also raised questions relating to budget allocation for elderly persons, prohibition of contract labor, village public phones, and general issue relating to Central Vigilance Commission Bill 2003. He participated in debates on many government legislation and took interest in lawmaking process. A member of parliament wrote on his passing, "Alas, the brightness of his judicial life was so blinding that people didn't take adequate notice of his parliamentary life. Maybe in his passing we will stop and reflect on the life and works of Nariman as parliamentarian per excellence. The Indian parliament is richer today due to his debates, interventions, and time can never erode the pillar of strength that Nariman has added to the edifice of parliament and parliamentary democracy. Mr. Nariman's contribution towards development of law is unaccounted. He practiced for 74 years. He appeared in several landmark cases. The list is very long, but to name a few, Golaknath case, SP Gupta case, TMFI Foundation, Supreme Court Advocate on Record Association, in which the Supreme Court took over the appointment of judges in higher judiciary. And in third and fourth judges' case, the last one being where NJC was struck down, are his major contribution in the cases regarding judicial appointment. Apart from his autobiography, Before Memory Fades, Mr. Nariman authored several books, namely The State of the Nation, The Indian Legal System, Can It Be Saved? God Save the Supreme Court, You Must Know Your Constitution. Besides being a legal luminary, Mr. Nariman was a mentor to the young lawyers. I can share my personal experience. When I was young advocate, I was arguing in a court. The court was hostile. Court was asking several questions and the bench was not with me at all. But I was well prepared. I responded to all the queries and all my arguments were supported with the several rulings. I did not know that Mr. Nariman was also sitting in the court behind me. When the case got over, I was able to persuade the bench and the judgment was reserved. When I came out, Mr. Nariman also came out and he patted. He said, "Very well argued. Don't worry about the result. Your job is to argue. Press your point. Don't worry about the outcome. You have done your job well and keep doing it." Whenever I face a difficult, his words still resonate in my ears. He was very strict during the conferences for the preparation of cases, but was amenable easily in the corridors of the court or library too. During his leisure time, when he was not appearing in court, he would often come to the library too and read newspaper or chit-chat with the lawyers sitting next to him. Once a lawyer, known for his candidness, asked Mr. Nariman, "Nariman sahab, aapke practice kaisi chal rahi hai?" Nariman sahab was not offended, but he asked his staff to help him. Few months back, in his introductory remarks at Ashok Desai Memorial Lecture, he recounted fondly his days in Government Law College, where they were running a mock parliament. Late Shri Anil Dewan was the prime minister of that. Mr. Murali Bhandari was the defense minister, and late Soli Sorabri was the leader of opposition, while Mr. Ashok Desai was chief whip, and Fali was elected as the speaker. His address was full of wit and humor as he reminisced his past days. Passing of Fali on 24th February 2024 marks end of an era.